Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at elementaryOS. So we're just going to go to their website, click the download button. And we'll let this download. Okay, now that we've got the ISO downloaded, what we want now is to download a piece of software that can write that ISO onto our USB stick. And the name of that software is called Etcher. And we want the 64-bit app image edition of that. So we'll just save that in our downloads. Let that download real quick. And then you want to be sure to right-click on Etcher in your downloads and go to Properties. And then set the permissions to where the file can be executed. And then once that's complete, you'll just double-click on that to open it up. Select the ISO that we've downloaded, select your USB stick, and click write. It'll prompt for your password, put that in. And then once that's done, we're going to restart the computer, leave the USB stick in the computer, and strike F11 or F12. Check your motherboard book to see what key you need, and boot from the USB stick. And we've made it to the installer. Let's click next, English. Default keyboard layout. We want to erase the disk and install. Select our hard drive. Don't encrypt. I'll include third party. That's fine. And the installer is kicked off. We'll let that go. I'll speed this up for the video. Okay, and now we set up our username, super secret password, and name the device. And we can click on Finish Setup, and then log in. And elementaryOS is going to greet us with a welcome app. Click Next. And then I'll switch to dark. You can pick whatever color you'd like. Not going to turn on nightlight, and then I'll go ahead and check all of these for housekeeping. I don't have any online accounts, and the App Center lets you sideload applications like flat packs, and we're ready to go. Okay, now that the initial setup's complete, the first step I like to take is just to check for updates. So we'll go into the App Center, and it's the orange icon. It's a pretty cool little notification pop-up we had there. And we'll just click Update All. And I'll speed this next portion up in the video. All right, and now that the updates are finished, I'm going to show you guys how to download an alternative browser to Firefox. And in the example, we'll use Brave, but you could use Chrome, Chromium, whatever version of browser you like. And now that that's been installed, we'll open it and get it set up. So we'll click Set as Default. Click on the dark, and then uncheck both of these telemetry. And then we can pin the Brave browser to our panel. Click and hold and drag it over. And then we can unpin the web browser that comes with elementary. And then go into System Settings, Applications. And we can set it Brave as the default browser there as well. Here's a quick look at system settings. We've got elementaryOS 7.1, and that's built on top of Ubuntu 2204 LTS, and that's running in Linux kernel 6.2. We'll demonstrate fractional scaling. So go into display and change our scaling factor from low DPI to high DPI 2x, and you can see how large everything looks. And here's some of the icons. So we're going to go back in here and change this back to 1x. And that just kind of gives you an idea of what the fractional scaling can do. And now I'll show you how to set up Steam and Proton GE for gaming. So we'll just go into the App Center, search up Steam, install that. And we'll launch Steam from the App Center. And while that's loading up, we'll go ahead and search up Proton and download Proton Up QT. And then open Proton Up QT. And we want to add, and it should automatically populate with the latest and greatest. So we'll just let that download. And then launch Steam. And then pull up settings. And compatibility. We want to make sure that our Proton GE is selected in that drop-down and restart Steam. All right, let's check NeoFetch to see what we've got. And you notice it's not installed, but it tells you what to do. So you can just copy the command and paste that in. Press Enter on it. And then once that downloads and completes, we'll be able to run NeoFetch. All right, so we run NeoFetch. It shows us our kernel. Our desktop environment, which is Pantheon. And then how much memory we're using. Hopefully you found this video informative, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thanks.